Hello, welcome to today's session. We are going to see what is rubric in the Google Classroom. So Google Classroom gives us a new feature called the rubric. Through this rubric, we can easily grade the assignments. So we have seen in the last 2-3 videos that how to give an assignment either through the quiz or give a normal assignment. So in that assignment, we have also given a video on how to grade the assignment. So we have seen how to grade. In that grading, this rubric gives us an easy feature. Let's see what it is. So I'm getting into the classwork. I'm creating an assignment. So in that assignment, so I'm giving the title. So what the title is. So watch video attached and write short notes. So they have to watch the video that I am attaching and they have to write short notes on that. So instruction, do properly while looking at the rubric marks, rubric split. So I'm adding, I'm go to the YouTube because I have a video in the YouTube already uploaded. So I'm giving modular classroom Linux file. I'm searching. So the video which I have uploaded is appearing. I am adding. So this file gets uploaded. So now I'm entering into the right side. If you give assign, this will be assigned. So with the 100 points, but I doesn't want to give totally the 100 points, but I want to add some rubric. So go to the rubric. Create rubric. It is for helping in scoring. So first criterion I am giving, explain syntax of file. So the point is 10 points I am giving. Level is I am giving level 1. Description, describe, give proper. So this is one level I am adding. If I add a criterion, I am adding a second criterion. I am giving explain example file examples or give file examples. Give examples of file commands. So this is a description. This is level 2. I already have given level 1. This is level 2. Points, I am giving again 10 points. So description. Give example. If you want any other more, what are all the contents they want to add in the assignment, if you feel, you can give there. So I'm saving the rubric. The rubric gets saved. See here, the rubric. Level 1, 10 points. Give proper syntax. Level 2, 10 points. Give example. So this is the rubric I'm attaching. So while the students submitting an assignment, they should be noting these two level of rubric for getting their marks. So the total points again remains 100. Now I am giving the assign button. The assignment has been posted to the student. So it is posted. Now I am entering into a student view. This is a student classroom. I am opening in the other browser to show you how it looks. So this is the student. She enters the classroom. She can find the note assignment. See, brief notes on attached video, criterion, totally, sorry, this is the assignment which I submitted. So do properly by looking at the rubric split. So there are two criteria, 20 points. After watching the YouTube video, they can submit the assignment. They'll be looking, oh, so there are two levels. So first level has 10 points where they have to give syntax. Second level is again 10 points. Totally 20 points. They'll be understanding the rubric, the mark split up or grade split up of the assignment. Then they can now enter, not this rubric, they can enter for submitting the assignment. So they can now submit the assignment. View assignment, they can submit. So after viewing the assignment, they can add or create. They can add the file. Now that particular student created the assignment either in the PDF file, document file or image file. They'll be selecting that particular file from their device. It is a PDF file submitted as assignment. Open. The file gets opened. The student should click the upload. The file gets uploaded by the student. So see the taskbar. The assignment is submitted. Once the assignment is submitted, the staff can value the assignment using the rubric. So through rubric, what are all the options we can do is you can create a rubric, we can reuse the rubric, we can share the rubric, we can view and grade the rubrics for every individual assignments. So the file gets loaded, uploaded. So after giving the assignment, they can also give the feedback with the score. Now it is getting attached. If a rubric is scored, the students can see the score. So once they click on turn in, it will be able to, the staff can view the assignment. So turning in, so now it will be visible for the staff. I'm opening the Chrome for the staff. So the staff can go to the grades, grade. So this is watch video. One, there are two students in the class. One is assigned, still assigned, and only one student is submitted, turned in. The staff is clicking the assignment submitted by the student to grade with the help of the rubric. So the total grade is 10. Here they need not grade. They can enter into the rubric. So this is the submitted. So we have asked the example. So the student have also given the example and diagram. So give the syntax. We can check whether there is a syntax. Yes, they have written some syntax. So I can give 10 marks for the syntax. And for rubric, again, they have given some examples. So 10 marks, so total marks, sorry, here. If the file commands have given, I can give 10 marks. So total 10 by 10, 20 marks. Once I take the mouse cursor out, so I'm getting 20 by 20. 20 by 20 is the rubric, so total grade is 100. Once it is written, the student can be able to view the assignment. They'll be able to notify. And if we want to fill any commands, good. That can also be posted to the student. So with the help of this rubric, we can able to easily grade the assignment. So now I have graded. Again, I'm coming back to the student view. There you can look into the assignments, how it is being graded. It is graded. So the student can find it is graded. They can go to the assignment and check their score. See the 20 by 20. So syntax, she got a 10 marks out of 10 marks, and file commands also she got 10 out of 10, and they have also got the total marks in the assignment. So this is the way how staff assign the assignment, and through the rubric they can split the grade, and how the student again submit the assignment back, and how they are getting the assignment returned with the grade marks. So this is how the Google Classroom helps through for grading through the rubric feature. So hope you understand this video and you enjoy this video. Thank you. Stay tuned.